it later. Hey everybody, my name is Marlo, this is Doug. We're kind of tired of our wives and their Cricut machine.
Having all the fun.
So we figured that because it's a cord, it looks kind of computerish here, there's got to be a way for us to have some fun with this thing too.
First thing we're going to do, ladies, gentlemen, throw this out the door.
No instruction manual. We're guys, we can figure this out.
That's right. This was our first take, a little deep.
But what we're going to do today is one of the things that we've discovered with the Cricut machine is that we can actually personalize stuff with this using vinyl. We found a great source for vinyl. We'll share it with you a little bit later. One of the things that we're going to personalize is
this chair. It's Ralph's chair, but we all know that possession is 9/10 of the law.
As you can see, it says Ralph right on here. We figured that we're going to gift this to our buddy Nick. So we're going to put Nick's name right here.
And what we've done, we've already set the machine up. We've got Nick into the console here. I think it's called a console. I don't remember.
Sounds
good. We have our font set at 1.5 inches. Depth we have discovered works best at 2. And we're using Cricut Keystone font. So we're ready to go. I believe the paper is loaded. We're going to go ahead and load the paper. Or turn the machine on first.
We don't need an instruction manual. We'll get through this.
So I'll step around here. Marlo. There we go. Sounds ready. Load paper. Spell Nick.
That would be N-I-C-K.
N-I-C-K.
There you go, man. Okay, what do we do next there, Doug?
Well, as we said, we had it set at 2. Our font is 1.5 inches.
Now, the setting for 2 is what? That's the depth, right?
That's the depth, correct.
What is this one for here?
Absolutely no idea.
Well, you know, we really don't need to know that, I guess. I think our wives told us we're not supposed to touch that dial, right?
I think they said don't touch anything.
Yeah, I think
we'll... So all we do is we press cut and we're good to go.
Hey, I think it's working.
Sounds like a tool. Stick your finger in there once in a while and see if it's done.
That's okay, really.
Okay, we'll go ahead and back it out. Unload paper. Marlo?
I can actually see the same word right here. Okay, now what do we do next, Doug?
Well, we can take it off the pad.
Okay.
Just a pad over here. And then we just take our finger here and slightly peel back the letter. And it comes off.
Since we're guys, we're not going to line anything up at all. We're just going to kind of stick this on here. Now, of course, you can certainly take a little bit of extra time. Actually, you can use special
burnishing tool?
Actually, there's a tape, isn't there?
Oh, transfer tape.
Transfer tape, there you go, that you can put this on. It kind of keeps it nice and straight. You can line it all up.
So guys, we imagine that you could personalize your boat.
Oh, nice idea.
Toolbox.
I could put my favorite team on the back of my car too, huh?
That's true.
All right, Twins. Minnesota Twins.
Okay. Minnesota, probably. All the way this year.
They say that every year, though, because
I know.
They say that every year, too.
All
right, just like this. Now, like I said, this chair does belong to Ralph, but we're going to gift this to Nick, and he'll be pretty impressed that we're giving him a personalized chair. So, any other comments there, Mr. Doug?
I don't think so. I think we've done pretty well for our first project today.
Very cool. See you, everybody.
Peace out.
Peace.
From a land down under.